दिस इज डॉक्टर क्षिप्रा वाडीकर फ्रॉम AISSMS इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. सब्जेक्ट इज इंजीनियरिंग मैथमेटिक्स. टॉपिक इज ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन टू फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म. ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इज एन ऑपरेशन विच कन्वर्ट्स अ मैथमेटिकल एक्सप्रेशन into a different form so that problems can be solved more easily or the method of finding the solution becomes simple. Fourier integrals and Fourier transforms are useful in solving boundary value problems. For example, there are lot many applications of Fourier transform in theory of communication, wave propagation and heat conduction. Let us have a look on Fourier integral representation theorem. Fourier integral representation of the function fx, which is defined on minus infinity to infinity, is given by fx equal to 1 by 2 pi double integration lambda from minus infinity to infinity u from minus infinity to infinity f of u e to the power minus I lambda in the bracket u minus x du d lambda, where in every finite interval fx satisfies Dirichlet's conditions and the integral minus infinity to infinity mod of fx dx exists. Let us have a look on Fourier transform. Fourier transform of fx is defined as f lambda equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity f of u e to the power minus I lambda u du. And inverse Fourier transform of f lambda is given by fx equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from minus infinity to infinity f lambda e to the power I lambda x d lambda. Whenever we are talking about inverse Fourier transform, we have an integration with respect to lambda. Fourier cosine transform of the function fx is denoted by fc lambda and is defined as the integration 0 to infinity f of u cos of lambda u du. And inverse Fourier cosine transform of the function fc lambda is fx equal to 2 upon pi integration from 0 to infinity fc lambda cos of lambda x d lambda. Again, whenever we are talking about inverse Fourier transform, we have integration with respect to lambda. Similarly, we can define what is Fourier sine transform. So, Fourier sine transform of the function fx is denoted by fs lambda and is defined as the integration from 0 to infinity f of u sine of lambda u du. On the similar line, we can define what is inverse Fourier sine transform. It is 2 by pi integration from 0 to infinity fs lambda sine of lambda x d lambda. We will discuss one example. So here we have a function fx which is 1 in the interval mod x less than a and it is 0 otherwise. We want to find out Fourier transform of this function fx. We want to find out Fourier transform of this function fx. The function fx is 1 for the interval minus a less than x less than a and it is 0 otherwise. So first we will write down the definition of Fourier transform, that is f lambda. So it is initially the integration from minus infinity to infinity f of u e to the power minus I lambda u du. Now we can partition this interval minus infinity to infinity as minus infinity to minus 1. This is first partition. Second partition is minus a to a, and third partition is a to infinity. In the partition minus infinity to minus a, answer is 0. In the interval minus a to a, answer is 1. And in the interval a to infinity, answer is 0. So this integration is reduced to integration from minus a to a e to the power minus I lambda u du. Let us integrate it. So after integration, we will get f lambda as 2 times sine of a lambda divided by lambda. Lambda is not equal to 0. Thank you very much.